This is it. Ah, yeah, nice bunch of rapists, thieves, murderers. What you doing out here, huh? You looking for your next easy target?
Get in there.
Yes.
Falling back! Falling back! Cover me!
Okay.
Oh shit, what the hell happened here? Well, might be worth having a look around. I can use this.
Thank you.
Huh. That's interesting. That's kind of interesting. Marauder camp. These are the assholes who've been ambushing the roads around here. Fuel.
Can't let any of them get out of here alive. Bunch of rapists and murderers.
God damn it!
Okay. Okay.
Oh, shit.
First one down, now the rest of you.
many drifters you ambushed down there, huh? Many of you are there. That don't matter. Not enough.
I saw something.
Wait, you saw something? Freaks!
Hide from them!
He killed them!
That's all of them.
How many we lose? We're good.
Jesus, you're fighting with that?
He ain't got shit!
Awesome. That's it. You're done. How do you like that, huh? Being ambushed, you like that? You murdering sons of bitches.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive, the strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Something called law and order.
All right, let's see if they got an underground bunker around here. Scrap. More bounties.
Get in there.
Okay.
That's it.
There it is. Down the hatch.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Many of you probably don't remember the Cold War. But living through it was a special kind of hell. Every time you heard a plane flying overhead, you'd think for sure that this is it. That's the one coming to drop the big one on us. And we lived through the Red Scare. Man didn't know if his neighbor was an American who bled red, white, and blue, or a communist red to the bone. Made it hard to trust. My father, God rest him, taught me the only way to be safe in dark times was to go underground. Built my first bunker with him. But we couldn't build it out in the backyard, with a neighbor spying. Had to go out into the woods, a ways from the road, where no one would happen upon it. With a bunker, you knew that if the country went to hell in a handbasket, you could open that manhole cover, climb down the ladder, and you'd be safe. With your radio and your hoard of food and ammo. Things haven't changed. Better to dig a bunker than an early grave. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, Cope? How'd that work out for the poor bastards who own the one that I just cleared out? Huh? Not so good, I'm guessing. Since they were all dead long before I ever got there.
Better idea. That should do it. Fuel can.
I never knew that.
Some credits. Something new every day. Oh, who knew?
Nomads. How long you been up here, huh? Setting up ambushes, hitting supply runs. Bunch of murdering assholes. Can't let any of them get out of here alive.